Well, a very good afternoon and welcome back to day 7 of the Imagine Cruising 2023 World Indoor Bowls Championships. We're live from Potter's Resort in Hopton-on-Sea and we have another World Open singles match for you. It's Greg Harlow facing Jamie Walker. So let's have a look what we have coming up for the rest of today. Following this game at around about 3:45 will be Jamie Chesney taking on the English qualifier of John Wilson. And the evening game for your enjoyment at 7:30 will be Alex Marshall, MBE, taking on Mark Royal. Let's have a look at the officials for this one. The marker is Bernie Hill, the umpire Greg Brown, and on the shot clock is Mike Davies. So let's get the show on the road and go live to this famous portable rink and join the man straight out of the shop window, Jack Jenkins.
Thank you very much, Jason, and good afternoon to all of those at home. Another fantastic crowd in here in the International Arena. Let's welcome out the first of our players for this match. First out this afternoon, we have a player with several national and British Isles titles to his name. He is also a former World Outdoor Triples Champion and Commonwealth Medalist. Please give it up for Jamie Walker. His opponent for this match has 12 WBT titles to his name, including the World Pairs, Mixed Pairs and World Match Play Championship titles, as well as being a former winner of this event. Please make some noise for world number 6, Greg Harlow! I will hand you up to Nick Brett and Jason up in the commentary box.
Thank you very much, Jack, once again. A very good afternoon. Welcome back to the Imagine Cruising World Indoor Championships for this year. As Jack's just let you know, in the commentary box this game is the one, the only, thank goodness, Nick Brett.
Thank you very much for the warm welcome yet again, Jason. Thank you.
So this is going to be an interesting Jack game. Jamie Walker is one of the UK qualifiers, came through the qualifying event from the Newport Indoor Bowling Club, which is in Wales. Been around a long, long time, obviously part of your Commonwealth Games team, Nick.
Yep, seen a lot of Jamie and obviously Greg. This is shaping up to be a cracker, really. You know, both played a number of games this week in the pairs on this, so both well used to the service this week.
Once again, if you are keeping up to date with us on the social media platforms and you can't stay with us for the whole afternoon, don't forget you can keep up to date with the scores later on tonight, either on our Facebook page or on the dedicated website, which is worldbowlstore.org. Nick's with me just for this game, so if you want to ask Nick a question, just pop it onto the Facebook or the YouTube channel chats. And we'll get him to answer that if possible. Specialist subjects are boats and history and that kind of stuff.
Yeah, thank you.
You're 3 feet, Jamie.
Greg playing with a Hensolite Tiger Bowl with the Extreme Grip? Mega Grip.
Mega Grip.
Mega Grip.
Size 3.
Has it gone down a size? Is it size 3, are they?
Yeah.
Getting old.
And we all?
Yeah, I've got a 3.
One red.
And the gap, the last one, please.
18.
Jamie's playing with the Taylor Blaze. It's got his initials there in the middle of the bowl, you can see. JRW.
Thank you.
Making it down to the green bowl. Oh, cracking stuff.
2 red.
Been a lot of discussion about different grips, Nick. I suppose it depends on, it's the player, isn't it, and how you hold a bowl. Everybody will hold a bowl slightly differently. I remember when you got taught how to play the game, there was this certain way you put the bowl in your hand and you turn it upside down. I don't think that tradition's there anymore, is it?
I've seen people with small hands play with big bowls. It's really what you prefer, I guess.
Oh, wow.
Just about hit the target and really good result.
Just ran right round his bowl.
Yeah. Two great bowls out of the first three from Greg, but he still needs another one here to win the end.
Your shot here, 10-inch gap. Greg's nearest is the one behind yours. One shot, Jamie Walker.
Well, decent start from both.
Certainly is. Notice this morning it seemed just ever so slightly slower than what it has been. I know obviously the rink as the competition goes on slows down anyway, does it's natural that the carpet will just slightly slacken off.
27 metres.
We time the green, like you know, Nick, in seconds, but what does that mean to you? So if you play on the green, let's say it's 18 and a half seconds and it drops down to 18 seconds, what do you think that is, a yard roughly?
Yeah, 2 feet to a yard, you know, thereabouts, which... I guess does make a difference, certainly if you're a half hour practice before the game or even your two trial ends before you play, depends on what session, it can speed up and slow down just enough to make a difference, because you're talking, if you're not getting within inches, feet, you know, you're not winning many ends, and the pace is just fluctuating, get yourself in a bit of a tiz-wuz.
Tiz-wuz.
Yeah. Certainly the way I play, you can. See, and there's the correction. He took away with the first, really, maybe just over and perfect. Foot correction, which is the easiest thing to do at this stage of the game.
The gap now, inch and a half.
Just wondering if it's just fell over out of sight. Not sure. Can't see out the window.
Got a feeling you might be right.
Just when Greg stopping, that was all of a sudden.
Yeah.
One green. too brief.
Well, Greg just needs to get down to Jamie's bowl, or the jack would be really good.
Looks pretty good here.
Oh, great bowl.
Yep, one top minute. Bowl that one. Jamie would just be looking to repeat his last bowl.
Jamie looking for something similar on the other hand and gets down to the jack.
Just a bowl higher, isn't he? But
didn't see the jack move.
One red.
Still one red.
The gap on the last one is just over 1 inch. You are 3/4 of an inch.
Loads of room then, it.
This red one.
Absolutely.
Front green one, 7-inch gap.
Don't worry, yeah. Clock's ticking down. Yeah, it's going to take it, yeah. Yes, it's not asked for a timeout, he's declared the end.
Yeah. No point wasting a timeout there.
No.
He's probably just going to throw that one down anyway.
Exactly. Quick question, Nick. We'll talk about the different styles of play when you were playing your pairs semi-final against the two lads from Hong Kong, Ken and Jason. Obviously, they are more deliberate, as in they take their time, they have a set regime, which is very noticeably slower than what a lot of players are. Does it put you off at all, or is it a distraction, or do you just have to understand and respect, I guess, that is their style of play and they're not doing it on purpose?
Well, yeah, that everybody's got a different speed of play, haven't they? You know, yeah, mine's fairly quick, and you know, when people are slow, I guess it can affect your rhythm if you are in any. But it is what it is. I'm sure some people in the game do play deliberately slow to try and affect your rhythm, but that is, you know, not against any rules whatsoever, is it? So. Yep. Yeah, I like to play quick, but if someone's going to play slow, that is what it is. And some people deliberately ask questions and want to know exactly where, what position stuff is. So it really is just is what it is.
Famous saying, is what it is.
Yeah.
Good start again from Greg Harlow. Jamie's not too far away.
Yeah, both settled into.
Very close, slightly favour red.
Well, down the funnel.
One red. Five inches short of jack high.
And the gap on my ball?
Gap on your ball, 9 inch.
Good speedy reply from Bernie. Just what Jamie would have wanted. Gets under the front, he's close. Hayes is pretty good for it.
One.
Well, kind of makes the angles a lot more difficult now. I mean, he can still wing off his own left-hand side bowl, can't he, if he plays something up the forehand?
Yeah, a little bit more positive, looking for your own green bowl. The other green bowl.
He didn't nominate that one.
I guess he's freed up the backhand draw for both of them, but... can be a ledge if Jamie's in the area.
Yeah, he could work back off it, can't he? See whether that or he just plays for to cut the countdown.
Yeah, he's probably going quicker for his own green bowl again, I would say, on this hand.
Corner, they're back to the jab.
Yeah.
Oh dearie me.
That's unfortunate to get that gap. So, decent end from Greg there.
4-1 after three ends.
Yep, some good bowls played from both players. Quick question, Nick. What first got you into playing bowls and why? That's from Claire Fletcher.
My dad played. Local team was short one night. Brett's got an old boy. Bring him along, make the numbers up.
And you beat them.
Yeah, 24 and a half.
No, meters. I won't go that far. But I played and social side, you know, played at a local club, you know, behind a pub, sit in the corner of the pub from what, 11 years old, listening to all the funny stories and back a packet of crisps and a half a Coke. But yeah, that was how I first got into it. Good correction. Jamie, will he go early at this on the forehand?
Yeah, I was going to say, he's never shy going, is he? Can't be too far away.
Depends on what edge he gets.
Yeah, it's gone.
Looks like he's made two on the re-spot. But,
I don't think they'll count, yeah.
No.
Inches.
Yeah, Greg with the Tigers will have to go pretty wide to hold the line on a good pace.
Yeah, big swinging bowl, aren't they, Tiger?
Jamie was a foot inside Greg's line, I think, and still well round him.
Oh, great bowl. Will it stop?
Thank you.
Well, Dyson, we're deaf there, weren't
Yeah, he's not going to get much more green. Not without hearing a clang. Jamie thinks he's quick, I think, by body language.
I say he's holding his hands out, yeah. He's right as well.
One shot, Jamie Walker.
Probably just thought to himself,
four, two after four ends.
Just make sure you've got enough to get round the red front two.
Yeah, exactly. Quick question, how is the shot clock controlled? Is it manually or automatically? We have one of the officials, so there's a team of four officials, one gets a rest. So Mike Davies is on the shot clock, it's a remote control device. They stand at the back of the smaller stand in the dark. It's a perfect job for Nick.
Jack Lenz, 27 and a half metres.
And they keep an eagle eye on the bulls as they're coming to rest. So that's where Mike is in the top corner.
Your ball 20 inch past. One red.
Greg will be looking to add another, but not make it any more inviting for Jamie.
As well played again. Yep, two great opening bowls from Greg Harlow.
Yeah, just fanned it up a little bit, whether Jamie will... Risk one
short,
or just try and draw
short,
to it.
He's playing forehand. I think he's going to play under his own for it. Well.
Oh, it looks pretty good.
Oh, good shot.
Perfect connection and gone with it reasonably well.
Yep, certainly has. Greg right on the inside edge of that mat, just trying to hold the bowl up as long as he possibly can.
It's coming pretty well again.
Yeah, he is. Just needs to run a bit further. Well played.
One minute. The jack off the ditch is 3.5 feet.
Gonna run the bowl off. I'll get the jack. Was he drawing? Drawing. No, he's going for the bowl or the jack.
Oh.
I thought it was just getting wrecked on that other ball then.
Yeah, made good contact, forced Greg to do it again.
To spin at a funny angle, that that ball.
Probably got it right on the top corner.
Yeah. Oh, well played. Yep. Two good balls down that forehand.
One shot, Greg Harlow.
Set score, 5-2 after five ends. Jack Land, 27 metres.
He's found one of the first two almost every end, hasn't he, Greg, so
yep,
far?
Yeah, he certainly has. Just the pace beating him.
Not a bad bowl by any means, but Greg's just about beating him in first bowl.
Again, it's all down to the pace. Good try.
One red. 2 inches. Jamie's 12.
Quite the running on this one.
Just wondering whether can Jamie just see enough of that ball to flick it away?
Well, he can, but Greg's made it a little bit more awkward with that one now, and it's, I guess it depends if Grammy's got 1 second or two, but the shot's available. Greg's might. You can, I guess, if you're a bowl wider than you want to be, you could use Greg's last bowl solid to do it as well.
Yeah, true.
Timeout called. Jamie has 4 timeouts remaining.
Yeah, there's no point in rushing that. I mean, it's 6-2. Chance to get in a 2 on this 6-10, so just wants to flick straight out.
That'll go pretty quick if you've not got enough weight.
One shot, Greg Harlow.
Set score 6-2 after 6 ends.
I was asking regarding the carpet and how many times we play on the portable rink. We had this question the other day. We think this carpet's been about 7 years, Nick, would you? About 7 years old, isn't it, the carpet?
Jack Lamb, 25 and a half
metres. It is 7 years. I think that was the answer when we did it before.
Obviously, it's hammered over the 3 weeks that we play on, but then obviously it gets taken away and stored.
Yeah, it's definitely not have 7 years as worth of a normal carpet.
Good start again from Greg. Unlucky. Great attempt. Oh, Jamie, you get down for the jack. Has done.
Yeah, he's played one here. Brilliant ball.
Opportunity for Jamie to put a little bit of pressure on this end.
Yeah, it'd be, if you just close this down a bit, it'd be really difficult for Greg now. It's got to be, plays the free side, doesn't want to leave that for Greg.
Big bowl, this N7, isn't it? Big bowl for Greg.
Well, yes, yeah, certainly when you're 3 down, if you're only going to drop a 1, it's probably not so bad, but you're either going to get the shot here or drop at least a 2. Doesn't look on the widest line you would need to be on, I don't think.
Not making it.
Well, from, you know, it was always going to be a key end, wasn't it? Jamie's, yep. Jamie's got a chance to level it up here with 2 to play.
seconds. He's quick again.
Three shots, Jamie Walker.
Well, still a big end.
Sure is.
Still a big end. Gets him right back in the set.
Set score 6-5 after seven ends. Jack Glenn, 27.5 metres.
Yeah, Jamie be looking to get the first one on it here, just start well, and he's not far away. Say that's a pretty good start.
Very good start. Well, Greg. Great effort.
One green. Gap on yours now, 3 inches. 7. Just one.
Yeah, he's probably favoured to swap to the forehand. Looks a little bit more of a percentage.
Yeah, definitely a better option, I think. Finishes quite nice there, does it not, on the forehand?
Yeah, good pace. You'll come all the way back. He's all the way up. He's really good. All the way up through the gap.
One green.
Jamie just got to be brave here. Get to one of either of the reds and sit.
Yep.
Because he won't want to be leaving it. Because if Greg just gets the jack, it's possible to drop a three, which will be
almost set over, won't it? Really.
Yeah, we'll leave you needing a four, but.
Yeah, still one green.
Same bowl will do him.
Oh, on his pace.
Still coming. Was just about a length, to be honest. All within a dustbin lid, this end.
Greg sits his own back one and falls over. It may just be enough for throw, I think.
Can he get back this time? It's just a little bit extra pace. That one also gives him the best back if Jamie does get in. I think he's intentionally gone out there and probably tried to sneak the spot as well.
Yeah. Just wondering whether if the two green balls peel away without hitting the jack. It's hard to tell from this angle whether there is going to be a contact. Probably might just make a contact.
Does look like it does, but it probably pushes the jack onto the red, and where does it go after that, I guess? Or does he just play? Just try and draw the shot, possibly make two or three if you just touch it, but
yeah, just tickle it.
Yeah. But you can go full out and see what you get. You know, it'd be unlucky to be any more than one down.
Yeah, definitely. I'd like to see whether they both go out. So if Greg could just hit that for me, that'd be lovely.
Hang on. See if we can message him.
Message him. Put out the telly.
Looks like he's just held it in a little bit.
Well, not far off. He gets to the back bowl and flops.
He's got the gap straight through the middle.
My goodness.
One shot, Jamie Walker.
Well, all that messing about for the first eight ends, we've got a one end shoot.
Now we've got 6-6 after eight ends.
Yeah, could have saved ourselves half an hour there.
Jack Glenn, 27 and a half metres.
Well, pretty good start when you got to win the end.
Stop clock.
Something's just disturbed him there. Not quite sure what that was.
Jamie's ball, jack high.
It's a 1-inch short.
Okay, you.
Is Greg going to go quicker? We've got to play in the forehand.
Yep. Been the jack.
Ben's quick if you've not got enough.
Someone's asking if you're playing Egham Trophy on Sunday, Nick.
Yes, I am.
Are you really?
Yeah.
Stop the clock.
Sure what that was, someone in the audience. Okay, everybody, we've just got someone just taken poorly at the moment, so we're just going to cut to an advert just to show you why Imagine Cruising is more than just a cruise. A fabulous picture of our sponsor's logo, Imagine Cruising. Been a supporter of the Sport of Bowls for the last 6 years. They sponsor a club down in Wiltshire in England. They offer various different package holidays all around the world to some absolute superb places. They're an exclusive and luxury global brand. They have offices here in the UK, Australia, New Zealand, and also in South Africa. So let's have a look at what we have coming up for the rest of today, just while we have a little break here. So shortly following this game will be Jamie Chesney taking on the English qualifier of John Wilson. I think he qualified from the Atherley Club down in Southampton. And then at 7:30 we have Alex Marshall, MBE, who plays Mark Royal. He is one of the sponsors' choices. Catherine Rednell was the other one who played in a great game yesterday evening. So just a little break here, folks. We'll just have a little chat with Nick and I. So what do you think? So the next game, Jamie Chesney, obviously you know Jamie's game very, very well. Have you seen John Wilson play much?
I saw John Wilson when he played Scott in the last round. I did have a roll with him first night he got
did
here.
You?
Yeah, and to be fair, he rolled very, very well, and also must have helped him during the game because he certainly played well against Scott.
Yeah, I've seen him a few times. He has a unique delivery, should we say. I know a lot of his supporters are on the Facebook and YouTube there. He gets somewhere with a little bit of a bump. I know they were giving him a lot of ribbing on the stream, saying that, but they call him the bouncing bomber. And then the evening game, obviously, Alex Marshall, MBE, and Mark Royal. Mark Royal just dropped out of the top 16, but he's been given a sponsor's choice wild card, so he'll be very keen to get the world ranking points under his belt for that one.
Yeah, he certainly will, but he's got a very tough opponent in doing so, hasn't he? Six-time world champion. That's not the easiest task you'd want when you're trying to get back into the top 16.
Yeah.
But it can be done.
It can be, and like you're saying, I think I've seen Alex play a few games now. He seems quite on form as well, doesn't he? He's been playing some fantastic stuff.
Yeah, he has. I think he's been out in Australia playing quite a bit. Obviously, played internationals here.
Yep.
So, you know, he certainly seems to be playing well enough. So, it should be a cracker.
Sometimes you get that feeling, sometimes you can overplay. Is that possible to overplay?
Yeah, it is. It is, for sure. But you've got to find that fine line of what's good for you, really. Some people like to play a lot. Some people like to play in mainly big events. So, as you're playing for something all the time. Some people just like to practice before big events, so it really is a you know, whatever suits you best.
Yep. So we're almost ready now to continue the play.
Yeah, so what's, I mean, obviously they haven't had to restart the end. Is there a time limit where you would need to restart the end?
It'll come down to the officials and both the players. It'd be at discretion, should we say. You can see they've had a chat there. The time, I think, was paused on, was it 13 seconds or 16 seconds? It seems that they've had an agreement to just reset that clock, which is very sporting. And I think it's probably the right thing to do as well, I think.
I agree.
Alan Thornhill's just come in there and said 10 minutes would be the time where you'd look at starting again. If I get to 9.5 and you're lying 4 against me one day, I will be. Just pop into the loo, mate. Yeah,
yeah. It's going to drink this bottle of water before we have them.
Alan's going to regret telling me that. Yeah, just a shame. I suppose it's just come right on the last end of a set, but can't be helped.
Yeah, not hindered or helped either of Greg's runners there. Jamie's, if Greg does get the jack clean and sit with it, it's very difficult for Jamie to cover it. Well, in between, is behind and got the spot, so.
That just needs to hit the target.
Yeah, probably needs to go a bit quicker, really.
In the area.
Well, he's hit something this time. What does he get? Both.
Oh, now how far's that ball spinning? Is the jack going out? Oh, he's been unlucky here, I think, has he? Has it gone out?
The ball's definitely out. It's now whether the jack's out.
One shot in the first set, Jamie Walker.
Oh, he was unlucky. That ball got a really funny spin on it, didn't it? Completely spun out of the rink there.
Yeah, it's almost gone, 80 degrees.
Yeah. So, Jamie Walker came back very well in that first set, was 6-2 behind after five ends. Strung three of the last ends together, and he wins 7-6.
Yeah, great set of bowls, really. I think Greg won the battle of the first bowls, but Jamie sort of hung in there, got a big three right, on the seventh end, which was crucial.
Jackman, 27.5 metres.
Your gap 8 inches. You do.
Well, Greg, he's unlucky.
Yeah, good pace, just a bowl under what he would have wanted.
2 green.
Depending on where Jamie puts this, I've got a feeling we might see the forehand runner again.
Two green.
Right on the front corner of the mat this time.
Well, yes, good bounce. Stayed with it. Question about the overseas qualifiers. So you can qualify anywhere as long as you're a member of that particular PBA branch. Obviously, Ken Chan lives in the UK, but he's still a member of the Hong Kong PBA branch. And we do have players that do decide to go to another country to try and qualify. I remember Steve Halmai, he went from Australia to America and he qualified out of America but was living in Australia. So as long as you paid your membership or your fees towards that particular country's branch, that is acceptable. Oh, great bowl from Greg.
Two shots, Greg Harlow.
Yeah, wasn't looking favourite to score two for a long time in that end, but one good shot on target and nice result.
Yep.
Jack Glenn, 24
shorter
meters.
Length, Jack, this time.
Yeah, it's sometimes when you know you got a close game, you've got to scratch around. Look at the last game. You know, Darren Bennett was really struggling. To be fair, not being critical, just to be fair. And then when he got in, brought that mat right up. That was a game changer for him. He's playing the same length, 23, 24 meters, but in a different part of the rink.
Yeah, can make a difference. Just yep.
Gap on Jamie's, 12 inches.
Yep, Jamie are looking to just get in a little bit closer with the second one.
Just missed the line, that was all.
Yeah, wait, it was good, really. Another chance.
Oh, yes. Okay.
No change.
Greg's last ball short.
18 inches short.
Running to get by.
Nope. Can it hold on?
Yeah, not sure whether it's done enough to get shot. I was hoping Bernie was going to tell us. Still plenty of room for Jamie to get in there, and if you can get a nice little touch, you can make two.
Yep, a little touch on the jack. Can even run off the pack, can't he, with his decent pace. Not reaching, though. Ooh, just short.
One shot, Greg Harlow.
Gone short one way, long the other.
It's an interesting tactic. I do that at my outdoor club because it's about 4 feet heavier up the hill, but people don't. It's not obvious that it's a hill, so I tend, when I'm playing down the hill, I bring the mat right up and play to the tee, and then up the hill I play full length, and you could be eight or nine nil up before you even start.
I thought that was just because you couldn't cast a jack properly.
Ow! Ouch! Oh gosh. Am I doing your game? Let's have a look. I am now. Yeah. Well, I'll be there with
With the jack cast in. What's he doing here?
I've just been told off online for giving the home secrets away now. Can't believe it.
Everybody's going to know
Everyone
now.
Everyone knows now. I'm never going to win a game again. Oh, dear.
Short.
Touching away.
Yeah, he probably needed just to sit back, really.
Down to the bolt.
Yeah, still room.
Yep.
Jamie plays the same bowl. You'll get onto the last and sit.
Yeah, you'd think so, wouldn't you? As long as he gets that decent pace sorted. Inside edge.
Yeah. Similar for Greg, good pace and he's close.
Yep, he needs to get down.
Yeah, just over what he wanted. Similar bowl for Jamie, or he could swap it over and just get to his own bowl on a forehand and sit, but there's no real reason for him to swap.
No, he's just played a really good ball, hasn't he?
One shot, Jamie Walker.
Gets him on the board.
That's
second set.
One yep. to 3 end.
Still not much in it.
Don't forget, tomorrow we have the World Mixed Pairs starting. So it's 4 games tomorrow, all mixed pairs. So that'll be a 10 a.m. start tomorrow. You get a line, everyone. Half an hour, so generous.
Jacqueline, 27 and a half metres.
Not far away again.
Now get back to the centre. That's what we'll be looking for yep. now.
Last ball is just past, about 5 inches past.
Choice now is he could go quicker or just try and rest on them, I think, with a nice pace.
I think so. I think with this ball at least, yeah. Oh, well played.
One net.
Something similar for Jamie Walker, should he require it. Just down to the bowl, turn the jack. You don't. It's one of them shots where it looks quite nice to play that yard or two, doesn't it, arriving, which you'd probably play on most club surfaces. But here you've got to really, really be careful. You don't get sucked into that and just play the dead place or wang it off.
Yeah, you've... Like Jamie's gone quicker here. He's, you know, he worked it out. He's floating up there, probably misses a yard, tight or wide.
Shot, well played.
Yeah, played it well. Played it well. Good result. Left one of his pretty close.
Two green.
Yep, Greg will be looking to do exactly what he did last time. It does look a touch wider than that, but obviously with a real good pace, it will come back.
It fall round it. No, it's staying up.
One green.
Similar bowl for them both, really. Jamie, we're looking to get in there first. If he does, Greg's got a live bowl in the ditch, hasn't he?
Yeah, it's gone back on the back, hasn't it? Yeah.
Yeah.
Sit centre line, it's pretty decent.
Two green.
Just draw down to the bowl again.
I think so. He's played a good pace twice, hasn't he? So there's no reason why he won't do it again. Well, I guess anything but the gaps now.
One shot, Jamie Walker.
I think you jinxed that. Nick.
Thanks, yeah. He took one out, he was two down, so. It's a pretty close game, is there? No quarter given, nothing easy.
Jack length, 27 and a half metres.
A few times he's just had that false start, hasn't he? I don't think he was put off by anything.
No. He had a little bit of a face grimace there, so I don't know whether he's got a pain in his leg or something, I don't know.
Too much for lunch.
One thing you do here is eat. Certainly good to reset himself because it's ended up pretty good.
Very well, yep.
Make Greg think anyway, because it is just a little short, so it's not clean all the way in. Greg didn't like, he wanted to have a look at the end, I think. Just to see how it was sitting.
That's acceptable, obviously, because he'll still get his 30 seconds.
It's not a case of you can't come up now, is it? You get your 30 seconds and you have to manage that however you want.
Yep.
He might be looking to go quicker here.
It's right on there. Look, part of the foot has to be on or above. Yep, as he let go, so that's acceptable. So you got the jack.
It's not far off.
Oh, dearie me. That was dreadfully unlucky, because that would have sat pretty close to the jack in the ditch, I think. It wasn't far away, was it?
Yeah, it would have been as nearly as on top of it as you could be. And not only that, he's got rid of one of his bowls and it's come on the spot. Jamie will still need to get pretty close.
Two green.
You can have another 10 goes at that and you won't hit that jack onto that bowl.
Yep, well played.
Guarantee himself a good second with this one. And let's see what he's got to work with his last. Down a pretty decent track. Can we get back to it?
Just up.
Ran over a black cat this end, I think.
One green.
Yeah, desperately unlucky with a runner. Just up with the draw, but Jamie will be looking to get to that last bowl and sit in, make it less of a rest for Greg. Get right back to the middle of it. There you go. Yeah,
good bolt.
Just what the doctor ordered.
Yeah, it was.
Don't think Greg would run at them. It's too dangerous to get flick his own out. So he's just got to lose a foot of pace. Well,
similar line.
Yeah, not too bad a line.
Needs to sit the bowl. Oh, brilliant.
Yeah, played a big bowl there, that's for sure.
One shot, Greg Harlow.
Set score 4-2 after 5 innings.
Some great bowls there. Jamie Walker played 2 crackers. Greg just managed to pip him with his last. Just having a little think with this.
Yeah, obviously crucial where he wants it and what suits him best.
Yep.
And what's happened when he's played it there before, what Jamie's done, I guess.
Jack Lamb, 26 and a half metres.
Two and a half feet. Gap on yours, 10 inch.
And Greg's last one?
12.
Thank you. Inside edge of Greg's will end up pretty good.
Yep.
2 green.
The last one, please.
Last one, 6 inches. See Jamie's bowl there, a couple of stamps on them, stamped to 2032, so that bowl is legal to play with.
Probably bowled the forehand not to put one there.
Yeah. It's odds law, isn't it?
Greg's looking at what bowl he wants to hit where.
Timeout called. Greg has 3 timeouts remaining.
He'll be aiming for the outside green one, yep. I think, looking to get inside edge of it to get him onto the shot bowl.
Going to get it clean?
Not far away.
Oh.
Looks pretty close for shot, doesn't
yeah.
it?
Yeah. Hard to tell. I mean, the green one looks a bit so deceiving when there's you're looking
called.
At it from
Jamie
behind.
Has three timeouts remaining.
If Jamie just tries to list his own short one up, it's highly unlikely that it would be on the right line to do that. So just got to try and pick a hand and draw the shot.
He can draw right round it on the backhand, I think, can't he?
Yeah.
Or play around the other one on the four. At least the backhand, he's got his own short ball. If he gets underneath, he gets to the red, doesn't he?
Yeah, good pace now, and hopefully miss his own green for him. That's what he'll be looking for.
One shot, Jamie Walker.
Set score 4-3 after six ends.
Well, seventh end was crucial in the first set, equally as crucial in this one.
Yep. Business end of the set.
Jacqueline, 28 metres.
Yes.
Well, foot or so for both of them, adjustment.
Yep, that's all it is, isn't it? 12 or 14 inches or so.
Yeah, Jamie's just adjusted a little bit.
Can he just get down in time for the bowl?
Yeah, generally when you're just out there, you're either on perfect pace or just slip by.
Especially on that hand, yeah. Is there still the two lines in down there, Nick? Is there still the fast, narrow line? Yeah, is that still there?
Yeah. A different pace, if you're not picking the track,
yeah.
You're generally not picking the pace as well. So, as I so very well demonstrated yesterday, of not picking the pace, I mean.
Oh, well played if it gets up.
Yeah, he could even sit him away.
Two green.
Yeah, I just remembered that. I think it's when I played you that year. You play, there's a line where you can almost play pretty straight, but like you said, if you're not within that 2 feet of exactly what you want, you can be made to look a fool.
Yeah, been there, done that. Yeah, very precise.
Yeah.
wider line is ideally the one you want to be on. It's a more natural line, but it's pretty quick out there. Jamie will be looking at where, you know, not only how it looks like now, but if he adds one in jack eye, Greg's got the two best back bowls and he can get in, get the jack out there. Yes, one of the green bowls may go with it, but he'll be a little careful what he does here. Holds two.
Timeout called.
But Jamie, he'll be quite conscious as well that Greg's got room to draw the shot. So it's whether you... brave enough to leave it and cover, or you go in to try and stop it.
Yeah, just maybe turn the jack first, or could you play down the forehand and finish almost level? Gets another one there, doesn't it?
Yeah, I mean you can still draw the shot down the forehand if you want, almost hide round the red bowl. But it's whether you want to leave the other two options to Greg. And with one bowl, it's job to cover more than one thing. Gets right back now, he's really good.
Oh, but he doesn't want to fall on it. Oh my goodness.
It's close to second, Greg, definitely one.
Oh, he's played a great bowl and got a...
slightly favour two.
Got the worst finish.
Yeah, I was dreadfully unlucky to... fall back against that jack, especially if it is just the one. It's a safer one, but I mean, if they got the touch on the other side of the jack, would have been making a fall
timeout
there.
Calls. Greg has two timeouts remaining.
Hugh's just asking, who does the winner of this game play? Well, they play the winner of this evening's match, which will be Alex Marshall MBE or Mark Royal. So a big crowd today this afternoon at Potter's. Been quite big all week, really. It was just that first day where it was the changeover day for people coming for the bowls or the New Year celebration. But, yeah, it's been really, really good.
He's chose the forehand runner. It's going to be positive. And what he doesn't want is inside edge of his own red and flick it away and get nothing.
Well, that saves a measuring.
One shot, Jamie Walker.
That's called 4-4 after 7 ends.
People are asking, do people stay on site when they play? Yeah, some go home. And if you're not playing for a few days, some people tend to go home and then come back. Some tend to stay. Correct.
Jacqueline, 27 and a half metres.
Sorry to correct you, Gary, but they don't pay. It's all free when they decide to stay. We don't charge them. It's free food and free drink and free accommodation.
Yeah, I get... and pretty good food and accommodation, I might say.
I don't know how you stay so thin. Whatever them pills you pop, I'll have six.
Yeah, I guess it depends on how many days you've got between games.
Yeah.
I think, you know, if you're not in the mixed pairs, generally there's a week between singles, first and second rounds, so there's an opportunity to sneak back home, maybe do a couple of days' work.
Yep.
That passed Jack Ivan?
Yes, 2 inches past.
Thank you.
My last bowl, how far through, Bernie?
Your last bowl, 3 feet.
Jamie, you're looking over.
Timeouts, please.
Correction on his first two.
Yeah, what? And he wants to make it here.
Yeah, he wouldn't want to be leaving it to his last bowl.
Yeah,
second at the moment. Greg will certainly be looking to beat that and get in tight.
Yep.
Yes, just one red.
Oh, foot more on his last, that's what Jamie will be looking for. If not, a little bit more, just so as he stopped Greg with trying to tuck it for 3 or 4.
Yeah, exactly. Well. Get in here. He is.
He likes it.
He is. Up the seam. Oh, Jamie. Great bowl.
One green.
Yeah, perfect. Couldn't have put it any better, really. Greg's still got just up if he wants it, but as we said before, not the easiest shot to play. Grammy's got two back bowls that are helping him now.
Yep.
Timeout called. Greg has one timeout remaining.
Greg won't want to get his own bowl and make it two down because he'll need a three. So he's probably forced into just trying to draw up to it and maybe nick the jack. Oh, but that is going all out four-round runner.
Try and jam it. I like how he held back for that option there, Nick.
Well,
I love that. Just see which way around he puts it in his hand.
Yeah.
How's his luck this time? He's in the area again. Oh, well played.
Trusty four-round runner comes to his aid.
One shot, Greg Harlow.
Yeah, certainly was a good shot.
5-4 after 8 ends.
So 5-4 going into the last end. Jamie just needs to score. He can afford to tie this, having won the first set 7-6. So could be played a bit like a tiebreak, hadn't it?
Yeah. He only needs, like you say, the one. Greg's gonna be behind the. He only. Behind the post, really, isn't he? Because whatever he does, Jamie's going to have a shot at something, isn't
he? Yeah, exactly. Someone asking about the Hong Kong pair again, how they qualified. So Jason Choi played with his normal pairs partner in the Hong Kong qualifiers. His partner that he was playing with was unable to travel to the UK. Therefore, we go to the rules, and then the rules state they are allowed to nominate either someone who's lost in the final or another member of the PBA branch in Hong Kong. Therefore, they nominated Jason to play with Ken. And they did very well. Just met some jammy sod at the side of me.
Yeah, the boys played well. Played well, very, very close to being here on Monday in the final.
Yeah, and in a way, not wanting to upset you or Greg, but in a way... that would have been quite nice for TV, and I think a little bit nice for the sport, obviously. Not taking anything away from you and Greg, but I just think it would have been nice. You know, something a bit different.
Well, it would have been a first, wouldn't
it? Yes, that's what I mean, yeah. That's why I was getting Nick to fill in my lottery card.
And the reason he's never won.
Not played for many years. I mentioned it yesterday to Graham and I said, I'll give you £1. Apparently it's been £2 for about 10 years or something.
Yeah, you're a little bit behind there. Well, pretty much as good as it gets from Greg so far.
Yep. Agreed. Does he go early and try and open it up?
Your last one. Don't know.
Yes, he can. He probably plays one more forehand draw to try and make it wider. But you wouldn't want to be short on the forehand draw to block it. Not bad if he's right up.
Well, will it bend?
Perfect.
Oh, wow.
Perfect.
Brilliant bowl.
Great bowl. Great bowl.
One green. One. Timeout called. Greg has no timeouts remaining.
Well, Greg's used of all of his timeouts. Don't see that very often.
No.
I think if you go to a tie break, you get one more.
Yeah, you know the rules. Well done.
Yeah. It's a wonder I do.
That's because you don't normally use any.
I broke my record last night. I used two on the same bowl.
And with pace.
He doesn't look too bad. He was just looking for a good contact.
Oh. Wow.
Yeah, in the area. Got... well, no result, didn't he really?
Oh, he couldn't have hit that much better. Probably just slightly too thick, maybe.
Left himself in trouble now. I suppose Jamie could go to cover. Cover the back. Greg's got one at the back. He's likely to play forehand quick. Jamie has the... Where's the back bowl? I don't know. He's now got the spot. Greg's got best back.
I mean, how does he remove that bowl and get the shot? I mean, like I say, he's going to have to hit it and come with it and stay quite close to it as well, looking that...
I think a very thin edge may do it, but it really is a thin edge because it's liable to get onto the red with a thicker contact.
Yep.
He's got no timeouts. He would have normally took a little bit longer.
Yes. Well, down the throat again.
Does he get
Can
back?
He get thin? No. Hasn't done. So it's going to be a single shot for Jamie Walker, and that is going to be a win for the English qualifier from the Newport Bowling Club. 1.5 sets to 1/2, and he will book his place into the second round. Thank you very much for joining me.
No problem, anytime.
Good luck in your next few games.
Thanks very much.
So let's have a look what's coming up for you for the rest of today. In around about 10 minutes time, it's going to be Jamie Chesney taking on the UK qualifier from the Atherley qualifier, which is near Southampton, which is John Wilson. And then this evening, 7:30, Alex Marshall, MBE, will be facing Mark Royal, the sponsor's choice. Back in 10 minutes. Thanks for joining us.